Hello guys, welcome to my channel. This is Uda Pandit and you're watching MEP Technical World. In this video we'll learn about basically types of power cable. Okay, so in this video we'll only discuss about as per protection, basically what are the types as per the mechanical protection. Okay, so let's get started. So this is the power cable. Okay, if you talk about its parts of power cable, so here this is the view of the power cable and this part is actually conductor. Okay, conductor, this can be made up of copper or aluminium. So these are the materials of this conductor. Okay, this is four core conductor, four core power cable. Okay, and above it, above the conductor, there is an insulation. As you can see over here, there is a red, yellow, blue, and behind it is black. So this is the insulation of this conductor. Okay, conductor insulation, it can be PVC, polyvinyl chloride, or it can be XLP, cross link polyethylene. Okay, so this is the material of the insulation. We'll discuss it in next video in details, different types of insulation, cable insulation. Okay, then another part is here we have a gap between this cable, so we fill it by filler. So this provides a smoothness or flexibility of the cable, okay, between each other. Similarly over here, as you can see above it, this is a actually conductor screen. Okay, so this is the conductor screen. So this will help to form the magnetic field in uniform manner. Okay, so this will protect the electromagnetic interference between other communication cable. Okay, then above it we have a inner PVC, this is the, we can say, cover. So inner cover, we can say PVC, which is made by PVC, polyvinyl chloride. Okay, then above it, this is the armored. Okay, armored, it can be a steel type or GI wires, most of them is steel type. Okay, actually steel can give mechanical protection of this cable. Okay, now finally this is the final cover, we can say enclosure. So this is the outer PVC sheath. Okay, PVC sheath. So these are the parts of the power cable. Okay, now come to types of the cables as per the protection. So there are two types of the cable as per protection. One is armored cable, so this is armored cable, and another is unarmored cables. So let's first discuss about armored cable. So basically what is armored cable? Okay, so armored cable is the metal layer provided to cable to increase the mechanical strength. Okay, so this is basically, we can say, armored cable gives the mechanical strength. Okay, so here, as you can see over here, so this is the steel, as you can see over here, so this is the armored actually. Okay, basically it will provide the mechanical strength, and material can be armored material can be steel wire or GI wire. Okay, now what are the advantages of this armored cable? If you talk about advantages of, because it is expensive, so why we are going to use this one? So it has some advantage. So first, it is high temperature resistant, so it can bear the high temperature in case of industry where we have a furnace. Okay, and any other activities where it generates more temperature, ambient temperatures, at that area we can use this armored cable. So basically this armored steel wire can provide the high temperature resistant protection, okay, against the high temperature area. That's why we use in industry armored cable. Then another is heavy mechanical strength. Again, this is most important or most advantage of this armored cable. Okay, so it gives mechanical strength. Most of time we use this also in underground. Okay, underground during the laying of the cable. When we have a maintenance or during the excavation above it or digging time, if anything hit on this cable, at that time this armor will protect from this digging device, digging equipments, maybe excavator, maybe a spadle. Okay, so another is metallic gland. It can be used in glanding purpose. Okay, so here as you can see, so this is the metallic gland where we can use in termination in electrical panel. So this will fixed over here in case any incident or during the pulling of this cable or any strength, at that time this will cable will fixed over here. It will not move in or outside. So that's why it will protect from losing the circuit towards the connection and other incident like a short circuit. Okay, so this will also can be possible in armored cable. Then low magnetic interference. If suppose we have a shaft, like generally we run the low voltage cable and high voltage cable in different shaft. Low voltage means ELV. I'm talking about ELV, extra low voltage, which can be data communication cables. Okay, Cat6 cable we can say. So at that time, if we have a situation like we have only one shaft, but we keep the distance between them near about 2 feet. Okay, near about 2 feet. At that time, if we use this, suppose this side is communication wire, okay, or data wire, riser cable, or okay, raceway we can say, and this side we have a cable tray riser for this cable. Instead of normal cable, if we use normal cable, you can say unarmored cable, it may be interference in this communication wire. So there might be noisy in the communication wire. So communication or data will be suffer from this electromagnetic interference. So this can be avoided by this armored cable. If we use this armored cable, so we will not get any interference with this magnetic, with this extra low voltage cable. Okay, so it provide low magnetic interference. Then moisture resistance. Then can be easily detect the earth fault. Okay, can be easily detect fault in case any fault occurs or burst any of the cable among these. We can easily find with the multimeter by we can say measuring, okay, or continuity test with the help of this armored and this individual cable. Okay, if you found continuity, then means its cable is damaged. So here we have option to detect it easily with the help of armored. Now another is also we can use this armored as a earthing as well. Okay, earthing purpose. So basically these are the advantages of the armored cable. That's why we prefer it in when we have a underground cable laying purpose, means outside of the premises like a building or industry. Okay, in instrumentation cable also we use armored. Okay, in tunnel. Okay, so these are the applications of armored cable. Okay, now come to unarmored cables. So cable without an outer covering of the metal is called unarmored. So without armored it's called unarmored. So here we, as you can see over here, this is the view of unarmored cable. Okay, here as you can see there is not a steel wire over it, so definitely it will cost less as compared to armored cable. Okay, so if you talk about its part again, so this is the conductor. Okay, this is the conductor. It can be copper or aluminium. Then here this is the insulation. It can be PVC or XLP. Then again it has a filler again. Then this is the outer sheet. So this is the PVC sheet. It can be used in low voltage purpose and sub main cable distribution. Okay, in internally. So hope you guys understand about basically what is difference between armored and unarmored cable. So hope you guys understand about what are the advantages of armored cable and what is the difference between armored and unarmored cable. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. Please like, share, comment and subscribe, and also hit the bell icon so you'll get notification regarding my upcoming videos. So thank you very much. See you again in next video.